Now, this is why plenty of us worry when things go bump in the night. While one mum and her daughter were at home asleep, two men broke in and stole their car right out of the garage.
Yeah, sadly, the experience of Justine and her daughter is not uncommon, but one in five Aussies having a similar experience of a break-in or security scare at home.
It's Neighbourhood Watch Week, and for more, Justine joins us now, along with Maria Bennett, CEO of Neighbourhood Watch Australasia. Ladies, thanks so much for being with us. Justine, we'll start with you. We're so sorry this happened to you. It's so... It feels so invasive when someone comes onto your property. Tell us about that night. What happened?
Yeah, I think you always feel a bit vulnerable when someone comes into your home. We just had, it was actually my husband, my daughter and I, so we were in our home in the Gold Coast. We're on two levels. So we came home after a nice evening out, went to bed as per normal, and when we woke up in the morning, we found all our back doors open and our garage door open to the street, and the car was missing and some personal items. So I think it's just that moment that you feel someone's been in the house while you're asleep upstairs, and I think you run through all the what ifs, like what if we disturbed them? What if they'd come and looked to see if we were there? So it definitely lives with you for a very long time.
Oh, most definitely. How are you? I mean, I touch wood, we've never been broken into, but I know people who have, and it's not necessarily just the break-in that disturbs them, it's the constant flashbacks.
It is, yeah. I mean, it's definitely something, and doing this piece, and I've been doing a few other pieces about this to get people aware, is you do remember every day. So I know we're going to talk a bit about some things that I've put in place, but every night when I check my boundaries, I am thinking about that feeling of you just don't want that to happen. And there's just simple things you can do, because it's mostly just opportunity that people see a door open or something and get in. So yeah, you do live with that. And I do have these things of, I still have flashbacks that I'm going to come home and the place is going to be broken into. I don't know why. I think it just sits with you.
It's your home, and it's supposed to be safe there. And it feels like you've been violated. I've been broken into before. It's horrible. Maria, let's talk through some of those basic security precautions that we can take around the house. Are these crimes mostly of opportunity?
Unfortunately, they are. It's a great time to talk about crime prevention during Neighbourhood Watch Week. And as you said, one in five people are victims of some sort of a breach of home security, just like Justine. A lot of people think it won't happen again, and Justine is rightly nervous, because in the last few years, 20% of people are victims of repeat burglary. So it's especially if they think your home is an easy target. There's a concept called target hardening, which basically means making your place more secure and less attractive for criminals. So anything you can do to ramp up your security and make your home more secure is a good thing to do. Some of my top tips would be to trim the foliage in your yard, so that gives burglars less places to hide. Store away your wheelie bins or ladders, anything that can give burglars easy access to higher entry points in the home, such as windows or balconies. Be vigilant about closing and locking your windows and doors. Sometimes it's as simple as just creating new habits and new behaviours. So 9 o'clock every night, go around, check everything's closed, check everything's locked, or before you go to bed, just do that one last check. Create that as a habit. The other thing would be, when you drive away, make sure your garage door is completely down, and of course, lock your gate. Gates are the first line of defence for your home.
Great. Maria, what would your thoughts be on security cameras? I don't know if you missed it just before. We were talking about rebates in WA from councils to suggest that people should get more on the street, on their home. Do you think it's a good idea?
I think it's a great idea. If you're getting a rebate to put in a security camera, they're not expensive these days. You can buy them yourself for like $60. These are probably much more upscale, upmarket ones that do a lot better job at film quality. Anything that you can do to target harden and protect your home, I think it's a great thing.
So how then can neighbours get together and help each other out? Is that a case of making sure you do know your neighbours, have a chat over the fence, and then when someone goes on holiday, you kind of offer up to keep an eye on the house?
100%. Knowing your neighbours and having that communication with your neighbours is one of the best forms of security that you can get. If you know that your neighbours are away but their gate's open or there's a strange car in their yard and you can phone them or they can phone you, it's truly just getting in contact with your neighbours. If you go onto our website, we've got little cute knock-knock cards that you can put your name, your email address, your phone number. There is a checklist that's been developed by D&D Technologies called Safe. It's at safegates.com.au. So there's also checklists on our website. Anyone can contact us at any time to get more information about crime prevention and target hardening.
That's great, Maria. Hey, Justine, what did you do to change your home security after that break-in?
Yeah, so the things that Maria was talking about, for me, first off, it was gates. So we didn't have a strong layer of a gating system. And when I talk about gates, you've got your front gates, but it's your side gates as well. So we created layers that people had to get through, because I still believe there's human error. I still think, you know, you let the dog out, you go grab the washing and you forget to close a door. Mm. That's pretty normal. So we put layers of gates in. We increased our security on our roller door. So to Marie's point, if that door doesn't close after 15 minutes, it will automatically, we put some AI and some robotics into that. So if we weren't here, if we forgot to close a rolling door, it would go down. But I have to say, the nightly, what I call inmate check or boundary check, I brush my teeth and I check every door and every window to make sure. And it's just a habit now. I can't go to sleep without making sure I've checked every single one of those doors. And even last night I did that check and I noticed, oh, the laundry door was open. So they're just simple errors that we make in our busy lives.
Great. That really is, it's so important. It's such an important week at Neighbourhood Watch Week. And again, we should all be safe, especially in our own homes. Maria and Justine, thanks so much for joining us today. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All the best.
Stay safe.
Thank you very much.